New tonight, could Ohio join more than a dozen states, including Kentucky, that don't require you to have a permit to carry a concealed weapon? One local lawmaker hopes so and is trying to get legislation passed. It is called House Bill 178. Nine on Your Side's Lisa Smith has more on how the controversial bill could impact you if it becomes law.
Carlnetta Flagg-Miles understands firsthand the impact of gun violence.
My son's name was Charles Flagg.
Charles Flagg was murdered during a robbery on October 17, 2015. He was 33.
There was two involved, but they didn't catch the shooter.
Her son had a daughter.
When he would come around, he was like, you know, the life of the party.
So the idea of legally carrying a gun without a permit, to her, is scary.
I see a lot of trigger-happy people with this bill, if this bill was to pass.
So the idea is, why all the restrictions on our law-abiding citizens?
Mount Lookout State Representative Tom Brinkman introduced House Bill 178. It would make permitless carry legal, allowing Ohioans to carry a concealed weapon.
A good guy with a gun has been able to intervene and stop a crime.
In Columbus, the bill has lawmakers split over numerous changes it makes to Ohio's concealed carry law. It broadens the definition from concealed handgun to concealed weapon. It would no longer require concealed carry training, and if you're carrying a concealed weapon and get stopped by police, you would not have to tell officers you're armed.
What the police officers tell us is they're always on guard. They have to always have their guard up.
However, several police agencies have come out against the bill. So have several firearms instructors, but not all.
I grew up with no guns in the house.
Today, Jeffrey Smith owns several guns. He's a Second Amendment advocate, a firearms instructor, and a supporter of HB 178.
I acknowledge that there are people who are fearful of guns. There are people who have had experiences in their lives that makes them fearful of firearms.
But he doesn't believe that should supersede his constitutional rights, and he says a license shouldn't be required.
There is no license required to exercise your First Amendment rights of free speech or of your exercise of religion, and nor should there be to exercise your Second Amendment.
There you go. You like that one?
Marcus Ziegler is also a firearms instructor.
I feel like every responsible gun owner should receive training, and I feel like I know from experience that most people, if this passes, they won't go get training.
This House bill has created a lot of debate on both sides of the issue, but there's one person who believes there should be more research on the access to guns.
And we don't really know what is a risk factor versus what is protective.
Dr. Cindy Malloy is a retired epidemiologist who investigates causes of disease and injuries in people. She says supporters of permitless carry are citing data indicating gun crime drops after states adopt the new law.
We now have pretty good evidence that it's not. It's a risk factor.
Meanwhile, in August of this year, the landscape changed for a lot of people.
You do have a crowd, to do something crowd. Dayton has had a substantial impact.
With nine dead and the Dayton community stunned, Governor Mike DeWine called on state lawmakers to introduce legislation to reduce gun violence. Brinkman says his bill has been stalled since the summer.
I'm practical. At the same time, I'm asking the committee chair to have hearings to continue the discussion on our bill.
Lisa Smith, 9 on Your Side.